स्तुत्भवन् विभक्तम् अनुप्राणत् विभक्तम् अनुक्रीणद्भिर्वृषः च त्वद्वाच्यम्. King Indra replied, "When I killed Vishwarupa, I received extensive sinful reactions, but I was favored by women, land, trees, and water, and therefore I was able to divide the sins amongst them. But now, if I kill Ritrasura and other Brahmana, how shall I free myself from the sinful reactions?" Sri Suga Vacha Rishayastatpar Karmya Mahindram Idam Apruvan Yajayishvayamapatram Te Hayamithinam Masmahipai. Sri Sukadeva Goswami said, "Hearing this, the great sages replied to King Indra, 'O King of Heaven, all good fortune unto you. Do not fear. We shall perform an Ashwamedha sacrifice to release you from any sins you may accrue by killing the Brahmana.'" 6-7. Hayamitena purusham paratmatmanam ishvaram istvamarayanam devam mukshyase pechakatvadhat. The rishis continued, "O King Indra, by performing an Ashwamedha sacrifice and thereby pleasing the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the Supersoul, Lord Narayan, the Supreme Controller, one can be relieved even of the sinful reaction of killing the entire world, not to speak of killing a demon like Ritrasura." So today's text, please repeat. Brahma,
Brahma,
Pitrinha,
Pitrinha,
Gogna,
Gogna,
Matriha,
Matriha,
Acharya,
Acharya,
Akhavan,
Akhavan,
Swadha,
Swadha,
Uthashaka,
Uthashaka,
Sutra,
Sutra,
sorry,
Va,
Va,
Api,
Api, Sujiran,
Sujiran,
Yasya,
Yasya,
Kirtana,
Kirtana,
Tam, Asumidhina,
Asumidhina,
Mahamakshina,
Mahamakshina,
Shraddha Anvita,
Shraddha Anvita,
Ashmadhi,
Ashmadhi,
Anusthitena,
Anusthitena,
Tattva,
Tattva,
Api,
Api,
Sabrahmachara Acharan,
Sabrahmachara Acharan,
Tvam,
Na,
Lipshyase,
Lipshyase,
Kim,
Kim,
Kala Nikrahina,
Kala Nikrahina,
Rama Pritriha Gogno,
Rama Pritriha Gogno,
Matriha Charya Bhagavan,
Matriha Charya Bhagavan,
Swatha Pulkha Kova, Sadha Pulkha Shakova,
Svada Pulsa Sakovapi
Sujedan Yashya Kirtatana
Sujedan Yashya Kirtatana
Tamasvamedena Mahamakena
Tamasvamedena Mahamakena
Shadhan Mito Shmabhya Anushtitena
Shadhan Mito
Atvapi Sabrahma Characharam Tvam
Atvapi Sabrahma Characharam Tvam
Nalipyase Kim Kala Nikrahena
Nalipyase Kim Kala Nikrahena
Brahmaha Pitriha Gogno
Brahmaha Pitriha Gogno
Swadha Pulkha Sakovapi Matriha Charya Bhagavan.
Oh, I missed that. Matriha Charya Bhagavan.
Swadha Pulsa Pulkha Sakovapi.
Swadha Pulkha Sakovapi.
Sudhiranyasya Kirtana.
Sudhiranyasya Kirtana.
Tamasamedena Mahamakena.
Tamasamedena Mahamakena.
Sadanvitosmabhiranusthitena Atvapi sabrahmacharacharam tvam
Nalipyase
kim kala nikrahena
Alipyasa kim khala nigrahena.
Brahmaha
pitriha gogno.
Matriha
charya hagavan.
Svada
pungha sako vapi. Sudhiranyasya kirtana.
Samashvamedhe
namaha makena.
Shradhanvito
vasma viranushtitena.
Atvapi sa brahmacharacharam tvam.
Alipyase kim khala nigrahena. Namaha pitraha gogno.
Namaha pitraha gogno.
Matriha-charya-hagavan.
Svada-pulka-sakovapi. Svada-pulka-sakovapi.
Sudhiranyasya-kirtana.
Sudhiranyasya-kirtana.
Tamashvam-medhena-mahamakhena.
Tamashvam-medhena-mahamakhena.
Shadhanvito-smabhiranushtitena.
Shadhanvito-smabhiranushtitena.
Atvapi sabram characharam tvam.
Atvapi sabram characharam tvam.
Nalipyase kim khala nigrahena.
Nalipyase kim khala nigrahena.
Brahmaha.
Brahma.
A person has killed a Brahman.
A person has killed a Brahman.
Pitriha. A person has killed his father.
A person has killed his father.
Gokna.
A person has killed a cow.
Matriha. A person has killed his mother.
A person has killed his mother.
Acharya.
Acharya.
A person has killed his spiritual master. Such sinful persons. Svadha. A dog eater.
A chandala.
One who is less than a shudra.
Va.
Api. Even.
Shudhiran.
May be purified.
Yashya.
Of whom?
Lord
Narayana.
Kirtana.
From chanting the holy name. Tam. Him. Ashwamedhena. By the Ashwamedha sacrifice.
Mahamakhena.
The topmost of all sacrifices. Shradhanvita.
Endowed with faith.
Ashmabhi, by us.
Anushtitena.
Conducted or managed. Hatva.
Api. Even.
Sabrahmacharacharam. All the living entities, including the Brahmanas.
From you.
Livyase.
Are contaminated.
Kim.
What then?
Kalanikrihina. By killing one disturbing demon. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivinoda Swami Srila Prabhupada. I think we'll just take all the verses. One has killed a Brahmana, one who has killed a cow, or one who has killed his father, mother, or spiritual master, can be immediately freed from all sinful reactions simply by chanting the holy name of Lord Narayana. Other sinful persons, such as dog eaters and chandalas, who are less than sutras, can also be freed in this way. But you are a devotee, and we shall help you. By performing a great horse sacrifice, you will please Lord Narayana. In that way, why should you be afraid? You will be freed even from the kill from if you kill the entire universe, including the Brahmanas, not to speak of killing a disturbing demon like Rikthasura. It is said in the Brihad Vishnu Purana, Namno Hiyayati Shakti Pabu Nihar 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 Hare. tavatkartum nashaknoti patakam pataki naram. Also in the Prema Vivrachan by Jagadananda Pandit it is said, Eka Krishna name papira yata papa kshaya babujan me se papi karite naraya. This means that by once chanting the holy name of the Lord, one can be freed from the reactions of more sins than he can even imagine performing. The holy name is so spiritually potent that simply by chanting the holy name, one can be freed from the reactions to all sinful activities. What then is to be said of those who chant the holy name regularly or worship the deity regularly? For such purified devotees, freedom from sinful reactions is certainly assured. This does not mean, however, that one should intentionally commit sinful acts and think himself free from the reactions because he is chanting the holy name. Such a mentality is the most abominable offense at the lotus feet of the holy name. Namno bhalat yasya hi papam puri. The Lord's holy name certainly has the potency to neutralize all sinful activities, but if one repeatedly and intentionally commits sins while chanting the holy name, he is most condemned. These verses name the performers of various sinful deeds. In the Manu Samhita, the following names are given. A son begotten by a Brahmana and born from the womb of a Sudra mother is called a Parashara or Nishara, a hunter accustomed to stealing. A son begotten by a Nishara in the womb of a Sudra woman is called Bhukasha. A child begotten by a Kshatriya in the womb of the daughter of a Sudra is called an Ugra. A child begotten by a Sudra in the womb of a daughter of a Kshatriya is called a Kshatriya. A child begotten by a Kshatriya in the womb of a lower class woman is called Swana or dog eater. All such offsprings are considered extremely sinful, but the holy name of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is so strong that all of them can be purified simply by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. The Hare Krishna movement offers everyone a chance to be purified regardless of birth or family, as confirmed in Srimad Bhagavatam 2.4.18. Kirata rantar pulinda pulkasha abhira sambhaya vannakakshathaya yenye cha papaya apas raya rash raya shudyanti tasmai prava vishvane nama. Kiratas, hunas, andras, pulindas, pulkasas, abhiras, sumpas, yavanas, members of the kasha races, and even other addicted to sinful acts can be purified by taking shelter of the devotee of the Lord, for he is the supreme power. I beg to offer my respectful obeisances unto him. Even such sinful persons can certainly all be purified if they chant the holy name of the Lord under the direction of a pure devotee. Herein the sages encouraged King Indra to kill Vritrasura, even at the risk of Brahmahatya, the killing of Brahmana. And they guaranteed to release him from sinful reactions by performing an Ashwamedha Yajna. Such purposely devised atonement, however, cannot relieve the person the performer of sinful acts. This will be seen from the following verses. Om Jnana Chimrandasya Chinandana Sulakaya Chakshuranminicham Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchikalpa Tirupyascha Tipasindhuyeva Cha Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Sri Sukadeva Goswami answered, when all the great sages and demigods were disturbed by the extraordinary power of Vritrasura, they had assembled to ask King Indra to kill him. Indra, however, being afraid of killing a Brahmana, declined the request. King Indra replied, When I killed Vishwaroo, I received extensive sinful reactions. But I was favored by the women, land, trees, and water, and therefore I was able to divide the sins amongst them. But now if I kill Vitrasura and other brahmana, how shall I free myself from the sinful reactions? Sri Sukadeva Goswami said, hearing this, the great sages replied to King Indra, O King of Heaven, all good fortune unto you. Do not fear. We shall perform an Ashwamedha sacrifice to release you from any sin you may accrue by killing the brahmana. The rishis continued, O King Indra, by performing an Ashwamedha sacrifice and thereby pleasing the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the Supersoul, Lord Narayan, the Supreme Controller, one can be relieved even of the sinful reactions for killing the entire world, not to speak of killing a demon like Vritrasura. And today's verse, Brahmana Vritriha Gopno Matriha Chaya Hagavan Svadha Mulka Shato Bhati Sutyeranya Shakirtana Tamaswami Tena Mahamakena Shatanvito Shmavya Anustitena Hatvapi Sabrahmas Chara Charam Cham Nadipsya Sekim Kala Nikrahena. One has killed a brahmana, one has killed a cow, one has killed his father, mother, or spiritual master, can be immediately freed from all sinful reactions simply by chanting the holy name of Lord Ryan. Other sinful persons, such as dog eaters and chandalas, who are less than sutras, can also be freed in this way. But you are a devotee, and we shall help you by performing a great horse sacrifice. If you please Lord Narayan in that way, why should you be afraid? You will even be freed even if you kill the entire universe, including the brahmanas, not to speak of killing and disturbing a demon like Vritrasura. So interesting points. One is that chanting Hare Krishna is extremely powerful. Another is if we commit sinful activities on the strength, the seventh offense of the holy name, then that power is definitely a lot diminished. And we also hear about the consequence of bad association. Here the demigods are quite bad association for Indra. So maybe we can think, well, I'm associating with devotees, but even when we associate with devotees, we should be careful. Because that can also be bad association. I actually heard a devotee telling, a devotee chanting 16 rounds, I won't mention any names, that it's not so important but with the quality, it's more quantity. So better you just chant 4 rounds, but chant it good. And this, back a long time back, it's none of the persons here. He actually started doing that until I found out, and I said, hey, you can't, this is for neophytes. Neophyte would tell, okay, chant 2 rounds, chant 4 rounds. But for a devotee, it's already a devotee, this is mine. That we need the quantity. And actually the proof of the quality is also quantity. Because if we actually get a taste for chanting, we want to chant more. We want to hear more. We want to hear more about Krishna from Bhagavatam. We want to hear the holy names. Because actually there's some taste there. Even though the taste is not there all the time, there's some taste there. Otherwise, who can continue? Who can continue year after year after year chanting 16 rounds every day? And maybe even increasing it. Practically impossible. So the proof of the pudding is in the taste. So if we endure over many years, it means there's some taste. It might not be the highest taste, there will still be a lot of austerity. And it is austere for the mind to chant Hare Krishna. The mind will constantly try. What are you doing? You're wasting your time here. Think about this instead. Listen to me. So this is bad association, this is asat sangha. So that can come from the mind, that can come from devotees, and that can come from all living entities. If they are not fixed, that's asat sangha. For a fixed devotee to associate with a person less qualified is asat sangha. That means he should not take association, he should give. And a person who is on that platform, on that level, who is actually not so fixed up in devotional service, he should never teach. He's not in a position to teach. He should simply listen. He should simply listen until he comes to the point where he actually understands. Because the only reason we are not fixed up in devotional service is because we haven't understood. So immediately when we understand, we are capable of making up, what's to say, manning ourselves up. Can you say that in English? I don't think so. We can take a decision and follow that decision. If we are convinced, like if we hear that out here in the forest, 10 kilometers from here, in Klampenborg, maybe 8 kilometers, I don't know, there's a treasure buried, $100,000 or euros. But you can only go, I only give you the map to find it if you promise me you'll go there bare feet at night time and you don't bring a torchlight. So you have to get into this dark forest and you have to walk 8 kilometers on bare feet and then you have to dig for half an hour for the treasure. Everyone would do, maybe not alone, yeah. I think even the devotees, because they can utilize the monies in Krishna's service. Because they see, here's the result. I'll get a result, there's an austerity I have to perform, but after that I can enjoy practicing unlimited materialities. So I will perform these austerities, but by chanting the holy names, we can attain billions of times much more than that. But it's not prayers, it's shreyas. It doesn't come automatically at the same moment we do it, or just after. So that means by chanting the holy name, we can perform austerities for many years, until the real result comes. So that's why it's difficult. That's what makes it difficult, because we are so used to being attached to the result. And Krishna makes it clear, kamanyamani karaste, mafa leshu kadachana, mafa, mafa, you shouldn't be attached to the fruits. Kamanyavadi karaste, you have the right to perform your prescribed duty, but you're not entitled to the fruits of action. So if we get to the point where we actually understand the power of the holy name, we will endeavor when we are chanting. When we get to the point where we understand the power of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, even though we hear it every day, that's nishtika, nishtita. He says, if all the shine is Srimad Bhagavatam,
which is our very means of conquest.
Yeah, how's this sentiment?
Nasta
Prayeshu Abhadra Isun Nityam Bhagavata Sivaya. Bhagavata Yutamata Lope Bhakti Abhadati Naishtiki. By regularly, Nishtin, Naishtiki is there. By regularly attending lectures in the Bhagavatam, Prabhupada mentioned daily. By regularly attending lectures in the Srimad Bhagavatam and hearing and serving the pure devotees, all that is troublesome to the heart is almost completely destroyed. Almost means it comes to the level of Nishtha. That's Nishtha, doing things regularly. Unless we get to that point where we hear Bhagavatam every day with attention, and we chant our rounds every day with attention, no question of Nishtha. We will still be on a Nartanimitya list. So we hear in Madhurya Kandam Bhini, and those of you who were here yesterday in the Bhagavad Gita class, you heard there are four kinds of aparans. Anyone knows them? Four kinds of aparans, or four kinds of anattas.
Aparat?
No, anattas, unwanted things in the world.
Anartas coming from sinful activities, sinful reactions. Anartas coming from pious activities, materially pious.
Yeah.
And there's anartas coming from bhakti, and anartas coming from
the obvious one.
Yeah, aparans.
Aparans. So these four, this is different kind of offenses we can commit. And that will cover the holy name. That's what aparat does, that's what anatta does. Anatta is sort of like sitting in there in our heart, stopping the connection to the soul, putting up a wall, you can say, or a shadow, or a cloud. That's why we hear of nama abhas. In Hainam Chintamani, about Nama Abhas, that there's two kind of Nama Abhas. There's what is called Pratibimba Nama Abhas, and then there's Chaya Nama Abhas. So Pratibimba Nama Abhas, people chanting on that platform can get ecstatic reactions, but it's extremely sinful. Because Pratibimba is like what the Mayavadis are doing. They might chant, but just to take advantage of the human being. But even there, they can get some ecstatic feelings. But because it's sinful, the holy name will not really reveal itself, himself. But on Chaya Nama Abhas, I mean, Chaya is shadow. So shadow is what we often speak about when we speak about Nama Abhas. It's like the shadow of the holy name. Or the holy name is like covered by a cloud. Like the sun can be covered by a cloud. So we can't see the sun, the light is there. So this child, the example is giving, because it's connected, like if you have a tree, our child is giving an example, if you have a tree, and the reflection in the water, that's reflection. And then there's the shadow. Which one, which of the two is connected?
Shadow.
The shadow. The reflection is not really connected. Like you can see the tree out there in the water, but there's not necessarily a connection all the way up to the tree. But the shadow has a connection to the tree. So when we chant on the Chaya Nama Abhas, Hainam Chintani says we can get all the way up to before Prema. That's the power of Nama Abhas. And it's not even the holy name. It's the reflection of the holy name. Or it's sort of like it's a distortion of the holy name, you can say. Or better reflection, child, shadow. But because one is endeavoring, Krishna just gives and a lot of mercy, even on that platform. But when one is standing on the level of Nama Abharat, there's very little progress. Probably give the examples like cooking with smoke. There's very little progress, if any. So, Nama Abharat should be avoided. And that's one of them that gives us anattas. That create anattas. And anattas is what stops Krishna from being present before us. It's like covering, like a cloud coming in before the sky, before the sun. So in Madhuri Kandambini, it's mentioned that all these four kinds of anattas can be mitigated in different ways from the different levels of from Shraddha to Prema. So Prabhupada often said it's a scientific process. So there it's very, very precisely described that there's five ways that one is gradually getting rid of the anattas. First one is partially, next one is substantially, next is almost completely, next is completely, and the last one is thoroughly, completely distinguished, erased, nothing left. So if you take Abharat of the four anattas, Abharat was one of them, the worst. So in Abharat, on Bhajana Kriya, they are, all these anattas are partially destroyed. Partially destroyed on Bhajana Kriya. So Bhajana Kriya is just when you start performing emotional service practicing. And being initiated. Prabhupada often gives that definition. So Bhajana Kriya starts when you're really serious about emotional service. Initiation, or when you're really serious performing sadhana every day, chanting 16 rounds, performing service throughout the day. That's Bhajana Kriya. So there they are partially destroyed, all the anattas. And when you get to the level of Nishtha, they are substantially destroyed.